Hello, all you Pokemon fans. That's right, it's yours truly, Gabriel again. Today, we'll be researching onto part 2 of my Kanto Pokemon. Since you watched the part 1 of my video previously, I'll be doing part 2. Let's get things started. Slowpoke, the dopey Pokemon, a water and psychic type. If Slowpoke's tail breaks off as it goes about its business, it probably won't even notice, and a new one will grow in quickly. The discarded tail can be tried for use in cooking. Slowbro, the hermit crab Pokemon, a water and psychic type. Thanks to Shellder's poisonous bite, Slowbro has grown even more scattered brain, content to stare at the sea and let its mind wander. It's occasionally startled into a moment of insight, but that moment passes just as quickly. Magnemite, the magnet Pokemon, an electric and steel type. Groups of Magnemite often cluster around transmission towers to suck up electricity from the power lines. They float above the ground by using electromagnetic waves. Magneton, the magnet Pokemon, an electric and steel type. Magneton is formed when three Magnemite link their bodies and brains together. These triples their electrical power, but their intelligence doesn't get a similar boost. Farfetch, the wild duck Pokemon, a normal and flying type. Farfetch always carries its trusty plant stock. Sometimes two of them will fight over a superior stock. Doduo, the twin bird Pokemon, a normal and flying type. While one of Doduo's heads sleeps, the other stays alert to watch for danger. Its brains are identical. Dodrio, the triple bird Pokemon, a normal and flying type. Dodrio has three heads, three hearts, and three sets of lungs. It can keep watch in all directions and run a long way without getting tired. Seal, the sea lion Pokemon, a water type. Researchers aren't sure why seal have shown up in Alola. They thrive in cold water thanks to a thick layer of blubber, but swimming in warm water can tire them out quickly. Dugong, the sea lion Pokemon, a water and ice type. When it's looking for food, Dugong can cut through the water at a steady pace. After a meal, it pulls itself up into the beach to rest in the sun. Warming up helps it process food. Grimer, the sludge Pokemon, a poison type. Most people in Pokemon dislike the industrial waste created by factories, but Grimer happily feasts on the icky slime. To survive, it has to maintain a certain level of germs in its body. Muk, the sludge Pokemon, a poison type. Muk really stinks, but some trainers are fond of it. Terrible smell and all. Recent efforts to reduce pollution and clean up the environment have also reduced this Pokemon's numbers. Shellder, the bivalve Pokemon, a water type. Shellder's shells are so tough and sturdy that they've been used to make shields in the past. If the Pokemon would just pull its tongue in, nothing could ever get to it. Cloyster, the bivalve Pokemon, a water and ice type. Ancient people used the spikes from Cloyster's shell to make spears. The shell is strong enough to withstand a bomb blast, so while it lurks within remains a mystery. Ghastly, the gas Pokemon, a ghost and poison type. Ghastly likes to lurk in abandoned buildings, where its presence sometimes causes strange lights to flicker. This gaseous Pokemon is hard to see, but it gives off a surprisingly delicate sweet scent. Haunter, the gas Pokemon, a ghost and poison type. Getting licked by the cold tongue of a Haunter is more than simply unpleasant. Such a lick can steal your life energy. These Pokemon live in darkness, and city lights can drive them away. Gengar, the shadow Pokemon, a ghost and poison type. The sudden onset of an unexplained chill might mean a Gengar is coming toward you. This Pokemon seemed to have misunderstood the concept of making friends. It tries to create a kindred spirit by attacking humans. Onyx, the rock snake Pokemon, a rock and ground type. Thanks to its internal magnet, Onyx never loses its way while boring through the ground. Its body grows smoother with age as the rough edges wear away. Drowsy, the hypnosis Pokemon, a psychic type. Drowsy feeds on dreams and has a particular taste for the ones that show the dreamer having a lot of fun. It sometimes show off its favorite dreams to friends. Hypno, the hypnosis Pokemon, a psychic type. Hypno's habit of sending everyone to meet its sleep so it can taste their dreams makes it to a dangerous Pokemon. But if you're exhausted and having trouble sleeping, it could be a big help. Krabby, the river crab Pokemon, a water type. Krabby digs holes in sandy beaches to make their homes. When the food supply is limited, they sometimes fight over territory. Kingler, the pincer Pokemon, a water type. When one Kingler waves to another with its giant claw, it's sending a message. They can't hold long conversations this way, though, because waving those heavy claws is tiring. Voltorb, the ball Pokemon, an electric type. Voltorb looks a lot like a Pokeball, and it was first spotted at a Pokeball factory. What's the connection? Nobody knows. Electrode, the ball Pokemon, an electric type. Electrode feeds by absorbing electricity, often from power plants or lightning storms. If it eats too much at once, it explodes. Execute, the egg Pokemon, a grass and psychic type. Execute is made up of 6 eggs that communicate with one another using telepathy. Crabrawler sometimes seeks out this Pokemon to pick a fight, but it can't stand up to Execute's psychic powers. Executor, the coconut Pokemon, a grass and psychic type. Executor's 3 heads all have minds of their own, and every decision involves a telepathic discussion. Sometimes one of the heads drops to the ground and grows into an Execute. Cubone, the lonely Pokemon, a ground type. When Cubone mourns for its lost mother, its loud cries sometimes attract the attention of Mandibuzz, who swoop down to attack. Some think that learning to cope with its grief is the only way Cubone can evolve. Marowak, the Bone Keeper Pokemon, a ground type. Evolution has transformed this formerly weak and frightened Pokemon into a fearsome foe. Marowak uses bones as projectile weapons against those it considers enemies. Hitmonlee, the kicking Pokemon, a fighting type. Hitmonlee can extend its legs like springs to deliver kicks with tremendous force. It's always careful to stretch and loosen up after battle. Hitmonchan, the punching Pokemon, a fighting type. Hitmonchan has the fighting spirit of a world-class boxer. It's extremely driven and never gives up. Lickitung, the licking Pokemon, a normal type. If you don't want to get licked, stay away from Lickitung. It uses its enormous tongue to investigate its surroundings, leaving an unpleasant-smelling saliva that can cause a rash. Coughing, the poison gas Pokemon, a poison type. The gases that fill Koffing's body are extremely toxic. When it's under attack, it releases this poisonous gas from jets on its surface. Wheezing, the poison gas Pokemon, a poison type. Rotting food gives off a nauseous gas that attracts Wheezing. Its twin bodies take turns inflating and deflating to keep its poisonous gases churning. Rhyhorn, the spikes Pokemon, a ground and rock type. A charging Rhyhorn is so single-minded that it doesn't think about anything else until it demolishes its target. Rhydon, the drill Pokemon, a ground and rock type. Rhydon's horn, which uses it as a drill, is hard enough to crush diamonds. Its hide is like armor, and it can run right through molten lava without feeling a thing. Chansey, the egg Pokemon, a normal type. Many other Pokemon just love Chansey eggs. They're full of nutrients and very tasty. Chansey move fast and can be hard to find, so catching one is a rare treat. Tangela, the vine Pokemon, a grass type. If grabbed by an attacker, Tangela can break away and lead the foe with a handful of vines. The vines grow back within a day. Kangaskhan, the parent Pokemon, a normal type. Kangaskhan will risk everything to protect the little one in its pouch. If you hear this Pokemon crying, keep an eye out for a young Kangaskhan who's just set out on its own. Horsea, the dragon Pokemon, a water type. Horsea wraps his tail around solid objects on the seafloor to avoid being swept away in a strong current. When threatened, it spits a cloud of ink to cover its escape. Seadra, the dragon Pokemon, a water type. When Seadra spins around in the water, it can cause a whirlpool with enough force to capsize a small boat. It sleeps among coral branches. Goldeen, the goldfish Pokemon, a water type. Seeing a school of Goldeen swimming upstream brings joy to anyone who's been spinning for the turn of spring. Some trainers are such huge fans that they ignore other Pokemon and devote all their time only to Goldeen. Seaking, the goldfish Pokemon, a water type. When autumn arrives, Seaking turns a deep red, just like their leaves on the trees. Fans of this Pokemon tend to argue about which of its features is more admirable, the fins or the horn. Staryu, the star-shaped Pokemon, a water type. A cluster of red lights glowing on the beach at night is probably a Staryu colony. Its red core glows at night, and as long as the core is whole, this Pokemon can regenerate from almost any injury. Starmie, the mysterious Pokemon, a water and psychic type. Getting close to a Starmie could give you a headache, possibly because of mysterious signals transmitted by its glowing core. With a shape like a many-pointed star, could this Pokemon have fallen from outer space? Mr. Mime, the barrier Pokemon, a psychic and fairy type. Mr. Mime often pretends to be trapped behind an invisible wall. It's a common pantomime trick, but Mr. Mime can make those walls real, and it's been known to attack those who aren't impressed. Scyther, the mantis Pokemon, a bug and flying type. Scyther's impressive speed in battle leaves its opponent's head spinning, which gives it an opponent opening to slash in with its sharp scythes. Young Scyther live in the mountains, where they form groups to train these skills. Jinx, the human-shaped Pokemon, an ice and psychic type. Jinx moves with its own swaying rhythm. It's right at home in Alola, where residents admire its singing voice and expert dancing techniques. Electabuzz, the electric Pokemon, an electric type. Electabuzz consumes electricity, but isn't very good at retaining the power within its body. It's constantly leaking electric current. If the power goes out on a calm, sunny day, it's probably the fault of Electabuzz. Magmar, the Spitfire Pokemon, a fire type. Taking a hot bath is a great way for some people to recharge. Magmar likes to do that too, but instead of hot water, it bathes in molten lava. Flames spout from its body in battle. Pinsir, the stag beetle Pokemon, a bug type. Though Pinsir is incredibly tough, it can't cope with cold weather, so it's right at home in Alola. Though it does find itself competing with the native Vikavolt, its horns can lift a much larger foe or topple a tree. Tauros, the wild bull Pokemon, a normal type. Although Tauros in other regions are known for their fierce love of battle, the Tauros in Alola are common enough that many people can ride them without fear. The practice of Tauros riding can apparently be traced in this region. Magikarp, the fish Pokemon, a water type. Magikarp splash about with abandon leaping recklessly out of the water, which leaves them open to attack. Though extremely lacking when it comes to battle strength, they exist in huge numbers. Gyarados, the Artosius Pokemon, a water and flying type. Gyarados is extremely destructive and its temper is legendary. Stories say it once burned an entire town to the ground in one night after the residents offended it in some way. Lapras, the transport Pokemon, a water and ice type. Lapras were once nearly wiped out by human activity, but thanks to legal protection, these friendly and intelligent Pokemon are now flourishing. Their lovely singing voices can often be heard near the water when they're having a good day. Ditto, the transform Pokemon, a normal type. Ditto can change its shape to resemble just about anything, and it sometimes uses this talent to befriend other Pokemon. Some are more skilled at duplication than others. Eevee, the evolution Pokemon, a normal type. 8 different Pokemon evolved from the amazingly adaptive Eevee, according to current studies. Its unstable genetic structure allows for this incredible diversity in evolution. Vaporeon, the bubble jet Pokemon, a water type. Vaporeon lives near water and some who see it wandering the shore think it's a mermaid. When submerged, its camouflage is perfect. It could disappear entirely in order to launch a sneak attack. Jolteon, the lightning Pokemon, an electric type. When Jolteon's fur bristles up, don't stand too close. It might be about to call down a lightning strike. Becoming friends with this Pokemon can be difficult because of its high-strung nature. Flareon, the flame Pokemon, a fire type. Flareon refers to rose berries with its fiery breath before chowing down. The temperature of its body averages nearly 1,500 degrees Fahrenheit, and the sac where it stores its flames is twice as hot. Porygon, the virtual Pokemon, a normal type. Porygon were first created about 20 years ago, and at the time, they were made with cutting-edge technology. By converting itself into data, this Pokemon could travel through cyberspace. Ammonite, the spiral Pokemon, a rock and water type. Ammonite's sturdy shell protects it from enemy attacks. This ancient Pokemon was restored from a fossil found at the site of an ocean that no longer exists. Omastar, the spiral Pokemon, a rock and water type. Omastar grasps food with its tentacles, leading some to believe it could be a distant ancestor of Octillery. Its heavy, cumbersome shell prevented it from thriving in the ancient past. Kabuto, the shellfish Pokemon, a rock and water type. Kabuto uses its hard shell to protect itself from attacks. This Pokemon species was plentiful a long, long time ago, but only a small number exist in the wild today. Kabutops, the shellfish Pokemon, a rock and water type. Kabutops is a swift swimmer and expert undersea hunter, but its body is ill-suited to life on land. The species went extinct before it could adapt to changes in its ecosystem. Aerodactyl, the fossil Pokemon, a rock and flying type. In its own time, this ancient Pokemon was the master of the skies. The fangs on that line, its jaws are like the teeth of a saw, and uses them to grip and tear at opponents. Snorlax, the sleeping Pokemon, a normal type. The stomach of a Snorlax can handle just about anything, which is fortunate because its massive body requires nearly 900 pounds of food every day. If it dozes off during a meal, it can keep eating in its sleep. Articuno, the freeze Pokemon, an ice and flying type. When Articuno flies its wings, the air turns chilly. This legendary Pokemon often brings snowfall in its wake. Zapdos, the electric Pokemon, an electric and flying type. When Zapdos is hit by a bolt of lightning, its power increases. This legendary Pokemon can bend electricity to its will. Moltres, the flame Pokemon, a fire and flying type. When Moltres gets hurt, some say it dives into an active volcano and heals itself by bathing in lava. This legendary Pokemon can give off flames and control fire. Dratini, the dragon Pokemon, a dragon type. Dratini's existence was mere rumor until the fisherman finally managed to catch one after fighting it for many long hours. It sheds its skin several times as it grows, and the skin is sometimes used in clothing. Dragonair, the dragon Pokemon, a dragon type. With the crystalline auras on its body, Dragonair is rumored to be able to change the weather. Because of this, farmers have long regarded this Pokemon with respect. Dragonite, the dragon Pokemon, a dragon and flying type. A Dragonite once rescued a man from a shipwreck and flew him off to a Dragonite paradise on a faraway island. This calm and kindly Pokemon is slow to anger, but once roused, its wrath can be incredibly destructive. Mewtwo, the genetic Pokemon, a psychic type. Scientists created Mewtwo by manipulating its genes. If only they could have given it a sense of compassion. And finally, Mew, the new species Pokemon, a psychic type. It is said that within Mew's cells rest the entirety of the Pokemon genetic code. This mythical Pokemon can turn invisible to keep others from noticing it. Well, everyone, that's all for today's Pokemon research video in Kanto. And to wrap it all up, we have here an awesome Pokemon rap. Hit it!
I want to be the best there ever was, to beat all the rest, yeah, that's my cause.
Electro, Diglett, Nidoran, Mankey, Venusaur, Rattata, Pharaoh, Pidgey, Seaking, Jolteon, Dragonite, Gastly, Ponyta, Vaporeon, Poliwrath, Butterfree.
Catch 'em, gotta catch 'em all. Pokemon.
I'll search across the land, look far and wide. Release from my hand the power that's inside.
Venomoth, Poliwag, Nidorino, Golduck, Ivysaur, Grimer, Victreebel, Boltres, Nidoking, Farfetch, Abra, Jigglypuff, Kingler, Rhyhorn, Clefable, Wigglytuff.
Catch 'em, gotta catch 'em all. Gotta catch 'em all. Pokemon!
Zubat, Primate, Meowth, Onix, Geodude, Rapidash, Magneton, Snorlax, Gengar, Tangela, Goldeen, Spearow, Weezing, Seal, Gyarados, Slowbro!
Gotta catch 'em all! Gotta catch 'em all!
Yeah.
Gotta catch 'em all! Gotta catch 'em all!
Yeah!
Gotta catch 'em all, Pokemon!
Ow. Kabuto, Persian, Paris, Horsea, Raticate, Magnemite, Kadabra, Weepinbell, Ditto, Cluster, Caterpie, Sandshrew, Bulbasaur, Charmander, Golem, Pikachu! Kangaskhan, Hypno, Electabuzz, Flareon, Blastoise, Poliwhirl, Oddish, Drowsy, Raichu, Nidoqueen, Bellsprout, Starmie!
Woo!
We're at the halfway point. Doing great so far.
We? What's all this we stuff? I'm doing all the hard work.
Break time's over. Here we go!
Metapod, Marowak, Kakuna, Clefairy, Dodrio, Seedra, Fireplume, Granny, Lickitung, Tauros, Weedle, Nidoran, Machop, Shellder, Porygon, Hitmonchan!
Gotta catch 'em all! Gotta catch 'em all!
Yeah!
Gotta catch 'em all! Gotta catch 'em all!
Yeah! Articuno, Jinx, Nidorina, Beedrill, Haunter, Squirtle, Chansey,
Pokemon,
Parasect, Execute, Muck, Dewgong, Johto, Lapras, Vulpix, Rhydon!
At least 150 or more to see. To be a Pokemon master is my destiny!
Charizard, Machamp, Pinsir, Koffing, Dugtrio, Golbat, Staryu, Magikarp, Ninetales, Ekans, Omastar, Scyther, Tentacool, Dragonair, Magmar!
Whoa! Catch your breath, man! Shake out those lips!
It's downhill from here! Just 24 more to go!
Now it gets tricky, so listen real good!
Sandslash, Hitmonlee, Psyduck, Arcanine, Eevee, Exeggutor, Kabutops, Zapdos, Dratini, Growlithe, Mr. Mime, Cubone, Graveler, Voltorb, Gloom!
We're almost home!
Gotta catch them all! Gotta catch them all!
Yeah.
Gotta catch them all! Gotta catch them all!
Gotta catch them all, Pokemon!
Hey.
Charmeleon!
War Turtle!
Mewtwo, Tentacruel, Aerodactyl!
Ammonite,
Slowpoke, Pidgeot, Arbok!
That's all, folks!
Catch 'em, catch 'em, gotta catch 'em all!
Ooh, gotta catch 'em all, Pokemon!
Catch 'em, catch 'em, gotta catch 'em all!
Ooh, gotta catch 'em all, Pokemon!
Catch 'em, catch 'em, gotta catch 'em all! Gotta catch 'em all!